Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can use Arduino to control this tiny stepper motor with push button. For example, this is assigned to 90 degrees clockwise. When I press it, it goes to 90 degrees clockwise and stops. And this goes to 270 degrees in counterclockwise and stops. For each, you can assign angle, speed and direction, but this one goes 365 degrees and 3 times slower. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. This is STPB-5, or 5th video in the series of push buttons with stepper motor. I've seen need for controlling stepper motor in different ways, and perhaps there are thousands or maybe millions of ways that this stepper motor can be used, and I spent quite a lot of time on writing code and experimenting and providing different solutions for different projects that people have. And in this one, we have one stop push button and then multiple push buttons, doesn't matter, 2, 3, 4, as much as the pins allow you to connect, you can have and assign different angle and different speed and different direction. I have introduction video to this motor, and the link for that is below the video, how this motor works, how this board is functioning and all the explanation. I'm not going to explain those. Make sure to watch that video separately, as this video will be very long. A lot of other videos that you can control this stepper motor with push buttons, with one push button, two push buttons, stop, with the potentiometer, and many other types. The link for those videos are below the video in the description. Also, I have video how to control it using your mobile device with ESP32 or Node MCU and D1 Mini. You can watch those video by clicking the link below the video in the description. Now let me explain the wiring here. I've kept the board in the same order so you don't make mistake. Blue, purple, gray, white. Blue, purple, gray, white. Pin 8, 9, 10, and 11 in the same order. This pin, because this motor is very small and if you don't have enough load, then we can connect it to Arduino. If the motor is heavy and you're controlling some kind of load, then connect external 5 volts, but in my case it is enough. And here I have this connector is connected already, so if you remove it, it will not work. It should be connected here. The red will be connected to 5 volts. And here the red is connected to 5 volts. The brown is connected to ground to this point. And for the motor, for this connection, you don't need to worry about it because you cannot insert it incorrectly. For this push button, we have 4 push buttons here. I've used this long pin push button. You can get them from Amazon, eBay, or AliExpress. And I've inserted them one pin in between. So one is empty in between, and this is here and here. So this is now the ground pin. Now, if I remove this, you will understand better. This is ground. Then I have a wire to a point that I will call it ground pin for the next one. And then from here, I have another wire that's ground for the next one. And that's ground for the next one. And then because I have 4 push buttons, we need 5 wires. And this one is connected to ground. So this ground will go to ground of Arduino. Then these 4 will go to the right pin of each push buttons in here. So all of these are connected to the right side of the push button, not on the other side, on this side. And the push buttons are in the same order. And here they've been connected from here in the same order to pin 2, 3, 4, and 5. And if you have more wires and if you have space, just connect them. If you need the wiring diagram for this, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Now let me explain the code. We are defining clockwise direction with number 1, do not change it, counterclockwise as 2, and stop as 3. And throughout the code, we will be using this CW, CCW, and stop so we can understand it better. And we are defining pin 8, 9, 10, and 11 for N1, N2, N3, and N4 of the controller board that is connected to the motor. And a stop switch, we are defining pin 2, that is the first switch that stops everything. And then stop type, 2 means stop and hold, and this will consume energy. In some application you need it, otherwise set it to 1, and 1 means just normal. Speed factor is just a value that is not used here, I'm going to delete it later. And these are the 4 important arrays. You see this square bracket here, it means it is array and it has multiple value, and this has only 1 value, so that's the difference. And I have separate video on arrays if you want to have a look at it, introduction, a crash course on Arduino, the link is below. So we have these 3 angle for 3, because I'm using 3 push buttons or 3 angles, I have defined 360, 270, or you can go even 7,655 degrees, up to you, whatever angle you want. These are the pins, pin 3, 4, 5, I'm putting them side by side accordingly. And for each push button, this is the angle, this is the direction. And you can have as many push buttons, as many angles as you want, but make sure that when you put the angle, also assign a pin for it, and also assign the direction, and assign the speed. For example, if you add here one more, let's say you want the push button to have 300 degrees, then also you have to define a pin. For X, for example, 6, you have to define the direction, CCW, for example, and the speed factor, fastest would be 1. So this way, you have to define it. If these arrays are not in the same length, for example, this has 4 elements, this has 4. If one is less or more, you will get error. If you wanted CCW, CCW, if you wanted just CW, put CW capital, because we defined them above in here. And then speed factors for each. If you want the fastest, just put 1. And if you want to slow it, just put 2, 3, and higher. But you cannot put 0. And if you need full explanation, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. The link for my course is below the video in the description. And here is a demonstration. At the moment, this is set to 90 degrees clockwise. And when I press it at this location, it goes to 90 degrees and stops. The speed is 1, which is maximum. Now it goes 360 degrees in 4 seconds, and if it will be 2, it will be 4 times slower, and so forth. And this push button, now if I press it again, I can stop it at any moment. So, and then we have 2 types of stop. One is just stop and the other is hold. This is a type of because this has gears, it will hold it anyways, but I made that option available. In some application, you need to hold something in a certain position, not to just turn it off, but consume energy and hold it. And that option is available. And this one is going 270 degrees. And now if you log this from here, that will be 180, 270 will be somewhere here. Sorry, the other way. And this one is now speed is 3 times slower, but 365 degrees. And as you can see even the blanks, so it's much slower. But you can also slow it down further if you want. For example, this is going 90 degrees and clockwise direction. Let's make this 6. And in that, for that 90 degrees, it goes 6 times 4, 24 times slower. 1 means that 1 revolution is 4 seconds, and 2 means, and when you set it 2, it will be twice slower. So this is now 6 times slower. The code is now uploaded. Let me press this. You see that 90 degrees is taking that much time, and if I press it again from that point, it goes. Now, if you want to put it in a certain position before sending it to another angle, you can, for example, this is fast, I'm pressing it, you can stop it and press this and make sure it reaches to a specific location that you want, and then stop it. Now, all the switches will be waiting to send this motor to that exact angle from this position, which we call home. And if you stop it, this will be your home, and pressing any of these push button will cause it to go in that direction. If we want to change the direction, we just change this to CW or CCW, but you cannot have 0. If you put 0 here, the motor will not move at all. The smallest value, which means the fastest, will be 1, and you can increase it. And of course, if you increase it like very crazy, for example, this is 270 degrees, already it's a long angle, and if I put this 10, and if I put here 10, so the middle push button, now it will be 10 times slower. First push button in clockwise with a normal speed for 360 degrees. Code is uploaded. Now it should go 360 degrees. It will come back to the same location. So that is 360 degrees with regular speed. Now, if I set this to 2, this is just for demonstration, 2, and upload it, it will be twice as much slower. Now, I'm pressing this and showing you the counter, so you can see and understand that it is taking twice as long. And now, let's make this 5. Now, again, it will take 5 times 4, 20 seconds before it reaches back. Now I made it 10. Let's change the direction to counterclockwise. Now it will be 40 seconds. Now let's see how long it takes. I change the direction, so it should come back. Thanks for watching. This was how to control a stepper motor with multiple push buttons and sending it to different angles. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Let me now explain the wiring. The motor is already connected, so you don't do the wiring. From here, we have four wires. Pay attention, blue is on this side, white is on this side, and in here, blue is on this side, in this case. So it is coming from pin 8, 9, 10, and 11. These are accordingly, if you look here to this. If I flip it like that,